In basic terms, a blockchain is a distributed digital database. Blocks of data are organized in chronological order. The blocks are linked and secured by cryptographic proofs. The implementation of this technology across different industries is already changing how we work and live. The idea is that decentralized and secure blockchains allow for a world where we don't need to rely on third parties for networks or markets to function. However, experts generally agree that if this tech is to be more widely adopted, there's a core problem that needs solving. The problem in question is known as the blockchain trilemma. For it to make sense, you need to be aware of three different elements that are desirable in a blockchain: decentralization, security, and scalability. The blockchain trilemma refers to the idea that it's hard for blockchains to achieve optimal levels of all three properties simultaneously. Increasing one usually leads to a weakening of another. This article will examine all three elements in the trilemma and explain what each one is in more detail. Bitcoin and similar blockchain networks are decentralized by design. The whole structure is such that there is no one person or organization in charge. The network layer is open to anyone who wants to participate. As a result, control is fully distributed rather than held by one single entity. Decentralization offers the possibility of what is known as Web3. Right now we have Web2, the internet of today. It's full of sites and apps controlled by companies, but featuring content made by the users. One thing to note, however, is that because of how these distributed systems work, with a need for a wide range of participants to agree on the validity of any data, transaction times can be slow due to the way information needs to be shared and processed. And so, blockchains need to scale, which is to say be capable of handling more data at faster speeds. Additionally, the decentralized dream only holds if the underlying blockchains are secure. If a blockchain lacks security, then a bad actor can take control and change the data in their favor. This leads to the second part of the trilemma, security. It doesn't matter how decentralized a blockchain is if it lacks security. A good blockchain network should be resistant to attacks from malicious entities. Centralized systems derive their security from the fact that the system is closed. Whoever is in control can guarantee the data is free from interference. But how is this achieved in a decentralized system where anyone can take part? The Bitcoin blockchain uses a combination of cryptography and a network consensus mechanism called proof of work. In terms of cryptography, each block has a kind of digital signature called hash. Each block of data is connected in a way that can't be tampered with because any changes would alter a block's hash. Any attempt to change the data would be quickly identified by the rest of the network. The greater the number of parties, the harder it becomes for one bad actor to take control of the system. Scalability refers to the goal of building a blockchain that can support more and more transactions per second. Scale is required if blockchain tech is to serve wider society and possibly billions of users. But this is where a lot of blockchains still struggle. This is because decentralization and security are so fundamental to blockchain that they tend to be focused on first. Decentralization is so central to the ethos and goals of blockchain that it lies at the very heart of most recognized blockchains. However, by prioritizing decentralization and security, scalability becomes a challenge. The number of transactions a chain can handle can be severely limited. A centralized payment system such as Visa states that it's able to support 24,000 transactions per second. This is because the network is closed and free from considerations such as public nodes and consensus. The most obvious and basic solution to the problem outlined above is to reduce the number of participants confirming and adding to the network data in exchange for greater scale and speed. But doing so would lead to a weakening of decentralization with control handed to a smaller number of participants. And it would also lead to a weakening of security as fewer players means a higher chance of attacks. So here lies the trilemma: given the connection between the desired properties of decentralization and security, the fundamental design of how blockchain works makes it hard to scale. Increase one, and you weaken another. How do you push scalability without damaging decentralization, security, or both? There is no one golden solution to the trilemma. But given the importance of solving this problem, there have been a number of different approaches within the community with interesting results. Let's run through an overview of some of the most popular developments to give you an understanding of what's happening in the space. 1. Sharding is a method of splitting blockchains, or other types of databases, into smaller, partitioned blockchains that manage specific data segments. This setup takes the stress off a single chain dealing with all transactions and interactions on a network. Each partitioned blockchain is known as a shard and has its specific ledger. These shards can then process their own transactions, but a beacon blockchain or main chain manages interactions between shards. 2. One of the reasons the Trilemma exists in the Bitcoin network is because of the way proof of work works to ensure security. The need for miners, crypto algorithms, and huge amounts of decentralized computing power leads to a secure system, but a slow one. In proof-of-stake blockchains, participants involved in validating transactions must lock their tokens. There's no need for highly specialized mining machines. Adding more validators to the network is simpler and more accessible. 3. Both sharding and different consensus mechanisms are what are known as Layer 1 solutions. They look to change the fundamental design of the underlying network. But other developers seeking to solve the Trilemma have been working on solutions that build on top of an existing network structure. In other words, they think the answer lies in a second layer, or layer 2. A sidechain is basically a separate blockchain connected to the main chain. It's set up in a way that assets can flow freely between the two. The blockchain only records the start and end of the channel.
If you found this article useful, please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel. You can also visit our website, where you find great educational contents about cryptocurrency. As a member of our Cryptocurrency Academy, you'll have access to exclusive resources and tools to help you stay informed and make better trading decisions. Additionally, discover and join our Discord. Our Discord server will provide a supportive network of like-minded individuals who can provide guidance, advice, and encouragement.